Let's get you the visuals because they can speak so much more and tell you so much more than I can right now. What you're looking at on your screens are visuals of protesters. These are students from the Jawaharlal Nehru University. And they have been protesting. They are en route to the Parliament of India, where they want members of Parliament, elected members of Parliament, to hear their concerns over a fee hike on their campus. So Parliament still working. It's the first day of the winter session of Parliament, and outside, students of JNU are persisting in their march to reach Parliament. They say, the students say that they have a democratic, constitutionally given a democratic right to protest peacefully and make their way to Parliament. At least 50 students of JNU have been detained so far, is what we're hearing. Hundreds have been stopped by the police this afternoon first near their campus after they began marching towards Parliament amidst tight security. They are demanding a rollback in a recent hostel fee hike. The students then decided to change their path, change their plan, and try and make it to Parliament on another route. And that is where Sukhiti is right now, in the midst of all of these protesting students at the Saptajang tomb. So Sukhiti, I want to go across to you. What is the mood around you? What do you see around you? What is it like? Let us have a look.
Well, yes, Sarah, we are currently standing near the Safdarjung tomb. What you see behind me is the Aurobindo Marg street, on which you can see hundreds and hundreds of students. As far as all of these have now decided to sit on the streets here and protest here. This was the area where about an hour ago there was a lathi charge that was done by the Delhi police upon them. These students planned to head towards the Parliament, but because of the lathi charge, there has been this now this break for the students, now that now they've decided to sit here and protest here. All around, as you can see, there's heavy police force also here, Delhi police personnel as well as the paramilitary forces. We'll get you a voice of the JNU SU Students Union itself. We have the Vice President of the JNU SU, Mr. Saket Moon, here with us to tell us more on what the JNU SU plans. Sir, right now the students are here. The plan was to head towards the Parliament. Does that plan still stay?
See, right now, as the situation stands, the police, I think, has sent all the deployment in, I think, half of the deployment in Delhi here to stop unarmed students from marching towards the Parliament, because they're afraid of something, or the government is afraid of something. Right now, just beyond that barricade there, I think a couple of 100 meters away, there's around 2,000 to 3,000 CRPF and water cannons and all sort of, you know, police deployment just waiting for us to just to stop us. Right now, we are here. We have stopped here. We are sitting here peacefully, and we are demanding that the police, which has brutally lathi charged us, which has detained our fellow students, which has also lathi charged press media persons very brutally. Women have been mishandled, manhandled, and they have, and students were they actually pushed students on the ground and then lathi charged them. All this sort of a, you know, shameful and brutal behavior, we first of all condemn on the part of the JNU-SU. And right now we are demanding them that first of all you have to release all the detainees that you have detained in the morning. To the extent of my information, around 100 to 120 people have been detained in 4 different police stations, Vasankunj, Kalkaji, Badarpur, and Delhi Kent. And they have also been beaten up there, they have been manhandled, and they have to be first of all released and brought here. Secondly, our demand was that the high powered inquiry committee constituted by the MHRD this morning, it's a complete farce, because that entire notification does not talk of what is happening in JNU, does not talk of the fee hike or the hostel manual. So at least a second demand would be that until that inquiry is complete, all decisions taken in the 28th of October IHE meeting, including the hostel manual and the fee hike, have to be put in abeyance. They have to be put on stay, and the union has to be made a part of the discussion of the committee.
So the HRD ministry has now set up a committee to initiate a dialogue with the JNU Students Union. Apart from that, your VC has issued a video statement. Do you think that this could be a new beginning of a proper communication that could be established between the administration and the students?
We've been hoping for a dialogue for the past month. And even if you look at the VC that the Vice Chancellor released yesterday, it's nothing more than a thinly veiled threat. a threat that says that if you don't stop protesting, I will rustigate you, I will fail you. And it's quite shameful that a vice chancellor who has been missing from the university for the last 1 month finds time to tweet, finds time to write elaborate press notes and letters to teachers and faculty, make video messages, but does not find the time to come and enter into a dialogue with the protesting students. Secondly, the high-powered inquiry committee, as I said before, for us, we are completely in the dark as to who formed the committee, why it was formed, how the members were selected, what is it inquiring about. Nothing is clear, and who all will be invited to depose before the committee, that also has not been made clear as of now. So all these clarifications, we first of all, we want these clarifications, and that the decisions against which we are protesting should be kept in abeyance until the committee submits its report. So currently we have communicated the same to Delhi police, and they have assured us that they will take a delegation of the union office bearers to the MHRD to meet the secretary. But for that, first of all the or our fellow students who have been detained have to be released, because office bearers and members of the union are also there, and many other,
including your president.
Yes, all of them have to be released and brought back here. Only then will any delegation go and a dialogue process begin.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for speaking to us. So that right there is the JNU SU Vice President Saket Moon telling us that their primary demand at this point is that all the detainees should be released, including the president of the JNU Students Union, Oishi Ghosh. As of now, these protesters are here, not likely to move towards the parliament, as there is already a heavy security deployment there. Over to you.